Lots of goods, just like flooding out the Ozarks.
Yeah, the Ozarks.
Arkansas.
Yeah.
Arkansas, Texas.
Yep.
Alabama and.
Yep.
What else?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, them there right there. Right
yeah, because they get, because they know what's coming, and they think that they're going to be able to escape that, man. Hey, Pharaoh couldn't escape those plagues, man. He couldn't escape that, all right?
Something else.
His people got took down. So guess what? You so-called white people, you're going to be taken down in these last days. All right?
It's like a couple, about 3-4 days ago, I heard on the news that when it was raining real heavy in that Texas, Oklahoma panhandle, that corridor, that they issued a national a national emergency because those Ozarks was getting flooded. They issued a national, what do they call it? They called it a security risk. They said it was a national security risk that those the Ozarks was getting flooded. It's a national security risk.
Yep.
This is like
week. That's because they want to hide themselves, man. They know what's going to go down. They know what's going to go down, man. All right? And they trying to prepare for it, not realizing, hey, you're going to get to see it. And a lot of people, most of the people, you're going to be affected by it, man.
Huh.
The Lord's going to scare the shit out you people, man. All right? We're going to go back to
the
second
Exodus 8 and 18. And the magicians did so with their enchantments to bring forth life, but they could not. So there were lice upon man and upon beast.
Yep.
Then the magician said unto Pharaoh, this is the finger of God Yahweh.
Yep.
And Pharaoh's heart was hardened.
Yep. Hey, they didn't want to believe it, man. Because the other nations, they got their own gods, you know? He magnified the name of the Lord, man. Yeah, they under they relying on Hotep, and Yahweh's destroying their ass. You know? You niggas want to get down with
Egypt.
Kemet.
Yeah.
And this is the history of Kemet.
Yeah, getting crushed.
Kemet was getting fucked up, man, by our power, man. All right? And death to you niggas that want to befriend or call those type of men that seek after Kemet. A brother, man. Death to you. That's all I gotta say on that. Death to you, man. Go ahead,
Al. Exodus 8:19. Then the magician said unto Pharaoh, this is the finger of God Yahweh.
Yeah, this is the finger of Yahweh, man. Go ahead.
And Pharaoh's heart was hardened.
Yep.
And he hearkened not unto them.
Uh-huh.
As the Lord had said. And the Lord Yahweh said unto Moses, rise up early in the morning and stand before Pharaoh, though he cometh forth to the water. Say unto him, thus saith the Lord, let my people go, that they may serve me. Else if thou wilt not let my people go, behold, I will send swarms of flies upon thee.
Hey, swarms of flies. So he kept giving him warnings.
Frogs,
hey,
flies.
I just gave y'all frogs. I just gave y'all lice. You know, I just did, you know what I'm saying? I'm finna send y'all flies now. You finna get infested by flies, you know? Hey, when niggas have barbecues, you hate when flies come around, man. You constantly swatting at them, you know what I'm saying? You don't even like when flies is around you when you eat, man. But the Lord said he about to send a swarm of flies, man.
Nothing but.
All right? And one thing about flies, they deprive on everything that's unclean or dead, man.
Like y'all, example, when you see all them so-called Africans down there in Africa starving, with their bellies bloated, sick, they always got flies around them because they sick.
Yep.
And the flies gonna keep picking on sores and different things. That's what flies do.
That's right. That's right, man. Hey, that's what's about to happen to America, man, spiritually. All right? Before it physically gets taken down. All right? Go ahead.
Exodus 8 and 20-21. It's like, else if thou would not let my people go, behold, I would send swarms of flies upon them.
Not like that.
And upon thy servants.
Yep.
And upon thy people. yep. and into thy houses, on the houses of the Egyptians.
I'm asking questions.
So full of thorns.
Hey, so it's going. Hey, have you ever seen that movie? What was it called? We had all. It was with Charles Dutton. I think it was called Mimic. You saw that movie Mimic?
Big Roach.
The big roaches and shit. Hey, man.
Dressing gonna, up in cold.
Yeah, you just gonna see all some way out shit, man.
The giant roaches.
You know?
Walking on 2 feet.
Yeah, man.
With hats on.
I mean, just some way out shit, man. The Lord will scare the shit out you, man. The Lord can do stuff like that, man. But he sent them a swarm of flies. You wake up and you see a swarm of flies all in your house.
Better yet, them flies wake your ass up.
Yeah, man. and the noise. You gotta imagine the noise that it's making. That noise. That should've bugged you out, man.
Bug you out. Going in your mouth and in your eyes and in your ears.
You're gonna be agitated. You know?
Can't eat, you can't sleep.
Hey, that shit is straight. Hey, that's terrorism right there, man.
That's terrorism.
That's terrorism from the Heavenly Father, man. That's why the scriptures call, that's why the Lord is referred to as the King of Terrors, man.
Or the Lord of Flies. I get it.
Hey, man, the Lord will
the
get
Lord
your ass,
man. Send them flies
He's
at
He's getting
ass.
Ready to do that to America, man. Just to shake you people up. Because there's no belief of the Heavenly Father here, man. There's no true fear. There's no belief. There's no faith. All right? There's nothing here, man. Just straight plain wickedness, man. So it's necessary that the Lord, he has to do those things that he's done in the past to the modern day America. I mean, the modern day Egypt, which is America. He has to do that.
Which is Babylon.
Which is Babylon, man. He got to show the white man that you ain't in control of nothing, man.
Which is Sodom.
You may think you got it all because you ain't in control, but I'm going to make you fear too. So he gonna bring these plagues to judge you fucking devils, you heathens, and the two-thirds of our own people.
That's
right.
Alright?
This Exodus 8:22.
Wisdom of Solomon 11. And you can start around the top. Start the top.
This is Exodus 8:22. And I was severing that day the land of Goshen, in which my people dwell, that no swarms of flies shall be there.
That's how you knew that there was a difference between the Egyptians and Israel. All right? The Lord separated us from the plagues because it was the ass whooping of the Egyptians. All right? Just like he going, just like he, yeah, he had us covered with the blood. Just like in this day and age, the elect are going to be separated from the plagues, man. The brothers that's doing the right thing, and they'll be elect, and they'll endure to the end, they're going to be protected from the said plagues, man. It's the rest of you people that you're going to have to, it's going to take effect on you, man. All right? You're going to be victims to these plagues. All right? Just because you're an Israelite now, it ain't going to be the same as back in ancient Egypt. All right? The two-thirds of you, you're going to be, in the eyes of the Lord, you in the same boat with the heathen.
That's right.
All
right?
So when the Lord sends those plagues out, you wicked-ass niggas and Hispanics and natives, you're going to be getting judged too.
That's right.
All
right?
The Lord going to fuck y'all up, man. You are here, you out here without a care in the world, man. You still want to stay asleep and be Esau's fucking slave, man. And be a wicked ass nigga or a wicked bitch. So them plagues is coming for you.
Right.
Go ahead.
Exodus 8:22. And I was severing that day the land of Goshen, in which my people dwell, that no swarms of flies shall be there. To the end thou mayest know that I am the Lord Yahweh.
That's
in
right.
The midst of the earth.
Hey, so like spiritually, that Goshen can represent on this side, the place of rest for the Akim, the elect, the ones that's not going to be taken or affected by the plagues, all right, by the famines, because the prophecies speak of that when there's a famine and everybody's fighting for food, the men of the Lord gonna be eating real good. They gonna have abundance. All right. In Job the 5th chapter, it said the Lord is gonna deliver his chosen ones in from 6 troubles. All right. Get that.
Isaiah 65:13. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty.
That's right.
Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed.
That's exactly, man. So it's going to be a difference. The elect is going to be doing okay. The Lord's going to be working with them and protecting them. And the rest of you, you're not going to have a hedge of protection. All right? You're not going to be well off. All right?
That's right.
Let's go back into it.
Exodus 8:23. And I will put a division between my people and thy people.
I will put a division between thy people, my people and thy people. So that's where he set the difference between the Egyptians and Israel. All right? Now that scripture, you know, we usually interpret it as the Egyptians are different than us, which that's true. But it was twofold because the Lord also was, he really meant that he was going to make a difference by how he was going to separate them from us by the plagues. All right? That's it on that. That was a good precept, brother. Now get that in Wisdom of Solomon.
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 1. Love righteousness. Ye that be judged of the
earth. No. Wisdom of Solomon 11.
Oh, I'm such an 11. My bad. Wisdom of Solomon.
Because this goes further into how the Lord is a man to be feared, man. All right, what them Egyptians went through, you people gonna actually see that, man. All right, the brother about to bring it out. Go ahead, all right.
Wisdom of Solomon.
Solomon,
chapter 11, verse 1. She prospers their works in the hand of the holy prophet.
It's 11. Go ahead.
She prospered their works in the hand of the holy prophet. They went through the wilderness that was not inhabited and pitched tents in the places where they lay no way.
This is referring to during the time of Moses and Joshua. And our people, when we pretty much we got saved out of Egypt, and we were led away where? Into the wilderness. So this is referring back to that time. During the time of ancient Egypt, our deliverance. Go ahead.
Verse 3. They stood against their enemies and were avenged of their adversaries.
We got avenged of our adversaries, man. The Lord basically paid those Egyptians a recompense. All right? They had us in hardcore slavery bondage. They whipped us on our backs. They had us building their pyramids. And their shelter.
That's right.
All right. We were serving them. And we served them for over 400 years. So it was time for the Lord to finally intervene. And he avenged us. All right. Go ahead.
Verse 4. When they were thirsty, they called upon thee. Uh-huh. And the water was given out of the filthy rock.
Yep.
Plenty rock. And their thirst was quenched out of the hard stone.
Yep.
For by what things their enemies were punished, by the same they in their deeds were benefited.
Yep.
For instead of a fountain of perpetual running water, troubled with foul blood, for a manifest reproof of the commandment whereby the infants were slain, Thou gavest unto them an abundance of water by the means by which they hoped not for.
Yep.
Declaring by that thirst, then how there hasn't punished their adversaries. For when they were tried a bit, I'll bet, but in mercy, chastise.
Jump to verse 15.
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 11, verse 15. But for the foolish devices of their wickedness, wherewith being deceived, they worship serpents void of reason and vile beasts. Thou didst send a multitude of unreasonable beasts upon them for vengeance, that they might know that wherewithal a man sinneth, by the same also shall he be punished. For the almighty hand.
And when you sin against the Lord, you're going to be punished, man. When our people, every time they kept sinning and going off, the Lord would put them right in captivity, or he would put them to death. That's what he was doing constantly. And when the nations, when they would go off and do their wickedness, the Lord would judge them too, every time. All right, he did it with the ancient Egyptians. All right. There was even a point in time when the northern kingdom got removed from out of Samaria, out of the northern Jerusalem, or northern Israel, and the heathens came in there. You got a bunch of Cushites and all types of Hamites coming up in there, and they call themselves trying to take our land and be like us, but they was worshiping their own gods in our land. And what did the Lord do? The Lord sent lions and bears and all type of beasts, unreasonable beasts, to kill off a lot of them. So they had to run the priests of our nation down there, and they had to learn our ways, man, to keep our customs, to even live in our land, man. So the Lord is terrible, man. So if you sin against them, guess what? He gonna punish you. All right? And America is one big sinful nation.
Is that a nigga with titties and a mustache?
Yeah, that's probably a transvestite, man. That's why the Lord's gonna send plagues on this place, man.
A nigga with because titties
things,
and a mustache.
Because of things like that. And there's so many of them in this society, man. All right? The Lord got a fucking... The Lord got something real serious for you wicked people out here, man. Go ahead, bro.
Verse 17. For thy almighty hand that made the world without matter, made the world of matter without form, wanted not means to send among them a multitude of bears or fierce lions, or unknown wild beasts full of rage, newly created, breathing out of their out of either a fiery vapor.
Hey, that said newly created creatures, man. Newly created beasts, man. Hey, we can't act like the so-called white man with his technology, and you know he got a lot of, it's a lot of scientists in them laboratories, man, and they do so much splicing. Jurassic World, they show you everything, man. There's so many different creatures that ain't been let out, man. That in this latter day, the Most High gonna allow this devil to unleash them out. All right, they finding different creatures in the sea that you ain't never even seen or heard of, man. All right, they finding creatures in the water that got fucking teeth
like
big
lions.
As like lions, man.
And no regular fish.
With two heads and shit, man. You don't know what's out there,
it's
man.
Dog mouse.
And the Lord's gonna put those creatures to use. if you realize what's brewing, man, and what this devil got up his sleeve,